Hello everybody, Jet here, and welcome back to our Costalton playthrough here, where everything is going well. We're actually doing quite well here with our, we're winning at the moment. I'm not sure what I want to go for. Do any of these give us more control or corruption? Attrition to enemies in my territory could be useful. Or just income. Or growth and replenishment. I mean, growth and replenishment is always lovely. There we go. I really should start pushing my devotion up more. We need a few turns there to replenish. I am considering selling some territory to the Norskans I'm trying to be friends with. But at the same time, I don't necessarily want to do that just yet. I think I'm going to push along here soon. Because actually, these guys have brilliant territory for me. That will probably annoy Wulfric, but I think trying to actually keep Wulfric, trying to control Wulfric, I think is a good idea, actually. We're also running a really nice income now, so I'm getting very tempted to actually start building another army, basically. There we go. Eventually... Sorry, I'm saying that and drinking dramatically, and I don't remember that I have the camera on. Eventually, we will obviously not worry about all of those thingy buildings, devotion buildings, because, well, supporters buildings, because we'll have won. And when we win, we get to confederate the Tsarina, which will be lovely. Potentially give us other threats, but it will be really solid for us. Back there. Behind all of our bastion, behind our northern bastion here, sits the Tsarina and her old beliefs. I believe that's the law. She follows the old ways, whereas we follow the orthodoxy, how is it phrased? The way they combined the religion. Her father combined the religion.
A boyar knows an ally when he sees one.
Heed me.
Don't like
Have
that.
You grown so?
This is the other reason about potentially giving these up, though it also would mean giving up the half of the territory, which isn't ideal. No, I'm not bothering constructing an outpost yet. There we go. I think I'm going to lose some territory to the Dark Elves there, but... And Daniel! Dark Elves and Daniel hitting me all at once. Yay! I will take the Pyrrhic victory! And the money, because there's no point replenishing units which are already dead. I want peace with them, but it's going to be hard fought. Can't get peace with Daniel. Let's say, I think I'm at the point where I should start putting together another force, but... Yeah. Ah, goddamn Norska faction raiding my territory, even though he's allied with me. No. The danger of bringing these guys on board is obviously...
Let's talk terms. But with any disagreements, there'll be a challenge.
No. Ooh, okay, so that's an easy way of bringing them on side.
I will subject you to...
Few things.
So they are fighting the Dark Elves, so actually I can use that very much to my advantage. By hitting that way. I do still want to take this territory, but it might have to wait for now. I need more income gen- Well, daft as it sounds, I don't need that here anymore. Or that. Oh, hang on. Farms do generate income, but... How much do farms- Farms generate 50. So that is a much better building. What's that? Increases by 50%, which would put that up to what? 150? So not really worth it. I'm also considering getting rid of that. Yeah, I'm going to push out some extra income buildings in these places because I didn't realise. It's potentially foolish getting rid of a hallowed forest, but at the same time, doesn't fit Gustavton. Ah, Strozzi Arsenal, there we go.
Speed to Orson.
And we have an Ataman decision up here. We'll take the growth. Sarl encampment's the one I want to level up first. And a bit more public order. Bollocks. I mean, we knew that was happening. Not much I could do about that. But we are going to fight Daniel quite heavily. He's not taking it. That's good. This is where I'm going to really want that second army, guys. Because Daniel is going to heavily raid, hit me on lots of places. And again, why I'm half tempted to pass some units over to Wulfric, to the World Walkers. Oh yeah, something I discovered, thanks to Linksy, I can change faction names, guys. So we can call ourselves Kislev once Kislev is done. Which I'd never realised you could do. Winter Pyre. Arrange a little accident. I'm not entirely sure that I should have, that was worth it, but
this is Orson's church now.
Okay, Grim, you're gonna get squished. Damn it. It's actually really annoying. Nope. I say nope, and then it's not told me to build down here. Okay, so the big cities get those really shiny buildings. I'm still very tempted just to squish Prague.
The Boyar of Kislev.
The question is, is it easier to just squish them? To bring them in? They are Kislevites. Unless they start doing annoying things in my territory, I will try to be good and leave them, at least for the time being.
Sheesh. I am Constantin.
I knew that was going to happen. There was honestly nothing I could do. And that is the problem with this territory as well, as it's very hard to hold. God damn you, Daniel. He's called Daniel, by the way. It's the name he was given in the trailer for Warhammer 3. Not the trailer, the playthrough they did beforehand. Oh, shit. I am actually quite concerned here. You know what? That third army is going to start being built because... Obey. Ice Witch Lord. There you go. Let's get both going to start with.
Betrayers! Betrayers all around! Hide your worthless forms! Find the enemy.
We can hope that it works. It probably won't, but... extra growth. I mean, I say that, I don't really need the growth here anymore. I just can't afford to level it up yet. Says me, who's about to start spending money on another army. I mean, I could have told you that was going to happen. Oh, they actually took it this time. Oh, he's sailing away. I'm going to start building another army, and I think I need to take the combat to them. So I'm probably going to push up here, then cross over and start hitting Daniel in his home territory. Maybe even go where Boris used to be. Get vengeance for the bear, father. God, there's Belagar as well. Oh, they are not doing well, actually. I might have to feed them some territory soon.
Go! Go!
Yeah, I'm waiting to start recruiting until I have this, until Mishka is ready. Tempest. Tempest, we're doing Tempest this time. Oh, I can also do another one.
Kneel to Orson.
Quick deal, Trey. Non-aggression. No.
For the good of Kislev.
This northern line is going to be hard. Ah, goddamn Helgrim. See, I think I might need to fall back. Whoa! Okay. I may as well stop being friends because he's about to be gone. It was a good idea to try and make friends with him, but he is getting his butt kicked. There we go.
But today you are lucky. Immediately.
Okay, I'm going to feed him some territory. Not Sarl encampment. I don't think I'm actually going to be feeding him any territory. I think he's probably dead. I got some money off him before he died. Growth building actually there. Agent of Brutality. I'm not really fussed by either. Campaigner or Battler? Battler. There we go. The issue is here, as I'm struggling to hold on to what I've gained. And that is really not ideal. Ah, oh, there's gone as well. I suspect Prague is going to take there. That's fine. Not yet. I may. I'm going to inevitably feed them some extra territory soon.
I said march!
Gonna feed them these two bits of territory at least to start with. I may swap them back later, but for now. Ice shards. So my income is going the right way. I'm inevitably going to retake there. And as I said, we might feed them into the World Walkers. We'll see. I should not be double timing. Why is there a ship there? Oh god, Wulfric! Wulfric! No! I think I'm gonna have to re-establish Wulfric myself. Which will bring him in as a solid, solid alliance. And hopefully bring him to the Order Tide. Let's just see. No. I didn't think I'd be able to piece out of them, but it was worth a try. Babushka! Babushka! Ooh. Goddamn perfect vigor, yes. Perfect vigor is just insanely good.
I usually negotiate with my sword.
Damn.
But today you are lucky.
I'm sorry, Wulfric. I think I can't save you. I mean, I could give him Sarl encampment and then work it down, but I don't want to. Tell you what, I am going to try some little cheesiness here. I'm saving, and then I'm doing some swapping.
Your demeanor tells me you aren't here to duel. Too bad.
I still want money off you.
Yes.
Sarl encampment for...
No problem.
Okay.
A
To be fair, I could give him this whole region, and it wouldn't actually necessarily be bad for me, because I'd lose Winterpire, which is the only real beneficial one there. All this to try and keep Wulfric the Wanderer alive, guys.
Disagreements, there'll be a challenge. I'll see it through.
We'd like to keep the Forbidden Citadel.
Without doubt.
There we go. So that's expanded him nicely. Obviously making him friends with us. Gives him some breathing space. I can always funnel stuff back into him later. Bit of a cheesy, cheeky way of doing it. But if it works, it works. Oh yes, Prague veterans. There we go.
Might grow.
That worries me. It's time. It doesn't matter who this is. They are being replaced. Maybe I should have taken the ability to recruit a second patriarch.
I accept only loyal.
Gislev's 1, 2, 3.
I deserve a larger retinue. I reject any who crave power. I demand absolute loyalty.
That'll do to start with. That is the downside here, as I may end up with control issues. But we'll see. As I said, long run, I might actually just funnel that entire territory into Wulfric, because actually, it's not a great region for me. It's probably more hassle than it's worth. There are better territories for me to have, and having him as a shield in the shield of the north, if I can keep him on side, will be really useful. And he's potentially a powerful ally if I can let him build up. The danger is if he gets vassalized. That's why I'm building up. I do not like that being in my territory. Don't care about either, really.
Bow to me. Governor of Kislev's lands. Only the most skilled may serve. I accept only loyal. I deserve a larger retinue.
Start recruiting them straight away. This is already a fairly hefty force. I'd like two of these.
I reject any who crave power. I demand absolute loyalty. I am Constantin. Oddheim Torch Herald. I am Truth.
The only thing about Winter's Pyre is obviously it's a port, and ports make money. I lost one. I lost an Ataman. That's fine. I may go crusading in the north long run. I think that's going to be one of my goals, is to be to clear the north of me, of all the chaos, corruption. I'd potentially go down into the Empire and deal with Brass Keep, because obviously that is a festering pit of corruption, for some strange reason. No! Okay. Ooh, that's cool. So Wulfric lost his homeland, but I've built him up elsewhere, and I will push back and I will feed stuff to him. Feels odd having him as an ally, but
execution.
Shit. Hopefully he won't stay in my territory. I mean, I might need to break that army out early. I don't want to, but if I have to, I have to.
Lord of all.
15.
Only the most skilled may serve.
18 by the time I've got a thing in. That'll do to start with. It's going to be a bloody expensive army, to be fair. Infantry focused. Yes, please.
Whatever the cost. March. March. March.
All other line.
Nope. Keep pushing my economy. Bollocks. You know what? I'm just giving it up. I'm giving up that entire region because it's too hard for me to hold. I'm ending up just going to deal with incursion after incursion. Doesn't mean I won't get it back later on. Because I fully expect Wulfric will betray me long run, because it's an alliance of convenience at the moment. But I mean, if I can keep him, and I can always do a bit of cheeky region trading long run. And by doing that, I free up my position a bit more while I'm building up another army.
Eradication!
No. Income, please. Ah, you cheating shit.
Obedience is devotion.
I'd usually negotiate with my sword, but today you are lucky.
Give them the whole region. It gives him a place to build from. I suspect he might die off, but basically these are just proving too hard to hold, and it's making him absolutely smacking love me. I don't want a full military alliance. Good. But I'm happy to keep a defensive alliance with him.
Supreme Patriarch
or Mother Kislev. Never yield.
What buildings give extra patriarchs? Up our income.
Chaos will be eradicated.
Nope. There we go. So even with this other army going out, my income is still okay. I'm a bit worried about Helgrim, but we'll deal with that. Prague is potentially going to be our next target, to be fair. Because they are expanding. I don't think I'm going to get a confederation off of them soon. So I think I might just break off everything and prep for a lightning war against them to take their territory. Pray to the skies.
Repel chaos.
We are both honored to serve the nation of nations.
The Empire.
But
now, Greetings, all you civilians.
Indeed.
Oh, don't actually mind me being friendly with Wulfric yet.
Bow before me.
Mistress of Ice.
Power is my right.
There we go. So I'm not usually a fan of doing this, but because we don't have so many things, she will pretty much be able to get everything. So actually that works quite well here. I would like a patriarch in here as well, because bears.
First of the bear cult.
Yeah. Gonna have income issues shortly. Which, to be fair, you could have probably told me from what I was doing. Shit. That's a problem.
I switch.
Well, we'll see how things go. As I said, I may be forced into a war with Prague, but we'll deal with that when we deal with that. Oh! She's lost territory in the Southern Oblast. Is she at war with the Empire?
The motherland never
fought. Damn chaos.
Your family will be hung.
Let me guess, you're going to war with me. I'm not going to call... Oh, he's already at war with them. Who cares? Wulfric, you need to start paying your dues. To be fair, it's territory I was going to lose anyway, so...
Man the walls!
This life the enduring!
To let your enemy live? Madness!
Storm summoner! We march forth!
For Urshan!
Come on! Oh, yeah, to be fair, let's pull him out of here, because I don't really need... Oh, I don't really need both.
Obey. Only
I'm going to drop him as well, because he's expensive.
Stay healthy, Kislevites!
The infidel dies.
Damn, it just destroyed it. Try and save up some money. I said, running two armies is expensive, but I feel I need it at the moment. I said, this is why I'm going to break all my alliances with Prague, guys. Prague is going to fall. I'm sorry. I need their territory. I need their city. I need the income from their city. The cursed city will fall.
Leave now if you are prone to time wasting.
See, it is going the right way. To confederate or not to confederate is the real question here.
Do not even consider questioning my authority.
I think I'm still going to keep trying to confederate them. Because we've got plans, other plans. Oh. Oh, so it completely does. Let's throw them a bone.
For Mother Kislev.
And we'll see. We'll keep an eye on it. Nice. Oh, that plus 50 is actually going to be huge. And that's obviously, yeah. Confederates. Catherine, which will be solid.
Only I spread truth.
Winter is our comrade.
Right, we are going to start double timing towards Sal encampment again. Because we need to protect my ally up there. And I'm saving money to level up Erengrad. Because that'll be where we'll get the most thing. He is teleporting about. He's now no longer in my territory, which is kind of ideal. So I might let him get away with that, but we'll see.
Kislev's troth is also yours.
No, I don't want a full military alliance with you. That would not benefit me at all. Nice.
Your bargaining must be in my favor, or we will not continue.
Aww.
No.
Kislev never rests.
Snowbringer.
Right. Let's move up to Stragoff. I don't need to recruit anything. I was considering recruiting some extra units, but I'm not going to.
The ice spreads. Hoarfrost, guide me.
Not spending any money. There we go. He is running away into the Empire. That's good. He basically got chased through my territory, which isn't ideal, but it's what it is. Do I have a bit of corruption at the moment? Ew. Do I have corruption, or is it just the tundra look? I tried to save Wulfric, guys, as best I could, but to be fair, he's dead. Nope. It was worth a try. Unfortunately, it didn't work.
Sister of Ice.
When I say that, it's not failed utterly.
The bear commands me.
Winds of magic buffs.
Of Kislev.
By Sigma's will, come in peace.
Nope, we're gonna have fun with them long run. We'll see. Long run, I've got a feeling I'm gonna end up taking Prague by force. I don't want to, but... Oh, is Helgrim actually coming back south? Oh no, he's going into Kislev. Katarin does not seem to be doing well. I think Katarin has overextended, because Katarin is over there in the Badlands. Which seems a little insane. Not the Badlands, the Darklands, whatever they're goddamn called. The land! Oh, I may regret splitting my armies. That is a hell of a chaos invasion in the north. Ooh. Shit. Sorry. And my reliability just got fucked. I can't afford another war at the same time. Interesting, they are a faction I want to go to war with, but I just don't feel I can do it yet.
The Orthodoxy. Never falter, never pause.
Keeper of ice magic. Will of the blizzard. My nobility is my strength.
I travel the world seeking jewels. Today you bring one to me. Okay.
I'm still non-aggression with you and I've still got access. I can fix things. I can fix things.
Pride,
I think.
Of the ice.
I should have gone to all these guys because I actually want their territory. You know what? I may load last turn save. That is something for me to work out for next time. As always, thank you very much for watching, guys. I do hope you are enjoying this. Please do like and subscribe if you are enjoying this. Make sure you hit the bell button as well. It really does help make sure you see my videos. And as always, an extra special thank you to our channel members and patrons. Monsterbound, Philip F., Unnamed, SpaceAce475, Coding Monster, and Jared Horn. And thank you to everyone for watching. Cheers all.